Hello everybody, my name is Victoria Lova and I am a former ballet dancer, an artist and a musician. I would like to welcome you to my channel and to my space of conscious living, where I will share with you my thoughts and my daily experiences that help me personally to stay focused and live a conscious life. In this video, I would like to discuss how to deflect negativity. A lot of people nowadays are using different techniques in order to cultivate positivity within them. They might use positive affirmations, meditation, yoga, and other practices in order to create positive field around them. But sooner or later, they will have to leave their shell and go out to the world, where they inevitably will encounter some everyday situations and some contacts with people. They most likely will be stuck in traffic at some point. They will have to shop for groceries, being surrounded by irritated and angry people. They will be running late for a meeting. They will encounter some disagreements with their colleagues at work and with their partners at home. And most likely, not all of them will pass the test of positivity while facing all those challenges. At the end of this video, I will offer you two practical techniques on how to deflect negativity in everyday situations. I would like to immediately remind everybody that I am always expressing my personal opinion, and you are absolutely free to either agree or disagree with me. I would also appreciate if you support my channel by subscribing, liking my videos, and leaving me a comment. I'm always eager to hear from you. When somebody is trying to offend you in one way or the other, you have to understand, you have to be aware of a couple of things. First of all, you have to understand that people who are trying to offend you are not happy people. And secondly, you need to understand that those people are trying to provoke you. They need your reaction. By getting your reaction, they get your energy. They become powerful and you become weak and easily manipulated. People usually react in three basic ways when they are trying to be manipulated by someone. First, they might get angry. Secondly, they might feel actually offended. They might feel offense. And thirdly, they are trying to justify themselves. All three positions are not the winning positions. They definitely indicate your weakness. Generally, try to become aware of one simple thing. If you are reacting to what is going on the outside screen, you are not in control. It is the easiest way for any manipulation, reaction. You see one picture and you start laughing. You see another picture and you start crying. You are shown third picture and you get angry, etc., etc., etc. You are get caught in the reactive circle. In order to break this vicious circle, you have to become an observer, and I'm planning on creating a separate video on how to become an observer. In this video, as promised, I will give you two practical advices on how to deflect negativity in your daily lives. So let's talk about how you practically can deal with people who are trying to offend you, who are trying to get your reaction. Let's say that somebody comes up to you and tells you that you are stupid. I'm just taking a very primitive example in order to make it very clear for everybody. If you are not self-aware, if you are caught in the reactive circle, then your response most likely will be, "You are stupid yourself." The moment you reacted to something, you automatically lost, and now you are easily manipulated, and your offender can get as much energy out of you as he/she wants. Just becoming aware of this fact gives you a lot of power. The first method I would like to give you today, I would call verbal Aikido. When you use the power of your opponent to fail him or her. So instead of getting into your usual routine, "You are stupid, no, you are stupid," stop yourself and say something like that: "Yes, I have also noticed that there are a lot of stupid people out there." So it might look at first like you are agreeing with the person who is trying to offend you, but it's not really true. You are just taking this energy and redirecting this energy towards others. You do not take it in. Most likely, when they hear this kind of response, they will think that you did not hear them, and they will try to repeat themselves. And that's okay. Just stay calm and just repeat, "Yes, I understood you. I also have noticed that there are a lot of stupid people out there." I can assure you that you will leave your opponent puzzled. And in this way, you are not being manipulated. You are in control, and you are manipulating the person who is trying to offend you. The second method is called "I'm not there yet." When somebody is trying to offend you in one way or the other, for example, they might tell you that you are stupid, that you are weak, that you have some physical imperfections, it doesn't really matter. Instead of reacting to it, try to compare yourself with somebody who is really proficient in this area. If somebody blames you that you are really stupid, tell them, "Yes, you're right, I'm not there yet. I am not as smart as Einstein. Or I am not as strong as Olympic medalist. Or I am not as pretty as a movie star." And then ask them a question: "But do you think I really can achieve that?" And just look at their reaction and enjoy yourself. Your atypical behavior will leave them uncomfortable, to say the least. They might not understand it right away, but with time they will feel that they have lost. They did not get your reaction, they did not get your energy, and you did not allow them to manipulate yourself. Instead, they got manipulated by you. Please try those simple techniques in your daily life and then share your experiences with me and other people by leaving a comment. Also, do not forget to subscribe to my channel and to like my videos. In conclusion, as always, I would like to sincerely thank you. It's time to make your move.